Hey, while you're in the first 5 seconds of the video, go ahead, like and subscribe.
Through mainstream media, you had movies like Passion of the Christ, you had Jesus of Nazareth, and the actor was always a white man. So you don't have to go to church to know that this is the image that's been pushed on our people.
Right.
But it's been pushed on our people. So when you think about Jesus Christ, no matter if you go to church or not, this is the image you have in your mind. A man who don't look nothing like you.
Bring it out.
That's why it's so easy for us to hate each other, because we don't see Christ in us.
Hey, so Raymarion had three questions.
Three questions, good.
He wanted to know the color of Christ.
Yes.
He wanted to know if God loves everybody.
Does God love everybody?
And he wanted to know who we are according to the Bible.
Let's start with who we are according to the Bible. We are the Israelites. We are the Israelites. Matter of fact, I want to start with the Christ. Let's go to Revelation 1 and 1. Come closer. These are genuine questions. All we do is we constantly got to bring out the image of Christ. We got to cast this down. Oh, well, Jamarion? Raymarion, listen good. Revelation 1 and 1. The book of Revelation, chapter 1 and verse 1. The revelation of Jesus Christ. So this is the revelation of Jesus Christ. We're about to reveal to you about Jesus, right? Because we only can know, find about Jesus is in the Bible. Read, jump to verse 14.
Verse 14. His head and his hairs were white like wool.
His head and his hairs were white like wool, right? We have two illustrations right here, right? But what is the world, who does the world identify with as Jesus Christ? This one here or this one? This one. A white man, pretty much. But when in fact, the scripture said that his hair was what?
White like wool.
So his hair, he had white, woolly hair. White in color and woolly in texture, like your hair, woolly. Like cotton, like woolly, right? So, which image has white woolly hair? There you go. Does this one have white woolly hair? No. But yeah, we've been fed this. It don't matter if you went to church all your life. Even through mainstream media, you had movies like Passion of the Christ. You had Jesus of Nazareth. And the actor was always a white man. So you don't have to go to church to know that this is the image that's been pushed on our people.
Right.
But it's been pushed on our people. So when you think about Jesus Christ, no matter if you go to church or not, this is the image you have in your mind. A man who don't look nothing like you.
Bring it out.
That's why it's so easy for us to hate each other, because we don't see Christ in us. And that's why it's easy for us to be submissive and receptive to the white man.
Right.
That's why when you go on a job interview, you want to put on your white man voice, on your white girl voice. Because why? This is the model of perfection. This is the model of holiness right here. Right? But we try to bring light to our people. We try to bring hope to our people. We try to bring a sense of pride. So far, this image right here, as according to Revelation 1 and 14, he has white woolly hair. But it don't stop there. Read.
As white as snow, and his eyes was a flame of fire, and his feet like a fine brass.
His feet is like fine brass. His feet is like the color of brass. Brass, not grass, which is green. I'm talking about brass. What color is brass, you know? What about you?
Gold.
Gold, yeah, a derivative of brown. There you go. Hey, my brother, what color is Christ?
He got gray.
He's what? He said his hair was white and woody. They had dreads. I know we had that image in our grandmother's living room at one point. With the Jesus Christ with the dreads, looking like this. No, that's not Christ either. According to the Bible, he has white woolly hair.
And an afro,
right, exactly. And his feet was fine brass, right? A derivative of brown. Read.
And his feet like unto fine brass, as if they burned in a furnace.
So that color of brass, which is a derivative of brown, if you take that brass and you burn it, would it get lighter or would it get black? There you go, point given. Right to the point. So what it's saying is that Christ is a dark-skinned man. So which one is dark-skinned? This one or that one? This one.
Can you do it one more time?
We're going to do it again for sure. I got to. What color is Jesus Christ?
White.
You just found out that today?
No, they said it was white at first.
Okay. But now we're going to prove, it again. Read Revelation 1 and 1.
Revelation chapter 1 and verse 1. The revelation of Jesus Christ.
So we're about to reveal to you Jesus Christ, right? Now we're about to get his description. Hey, my brother, what's your nationality? No, you're an Israelite. Yes, and you got to grow your beard. You got to grow your beard. Don't say, okay, do it. Remember, who's going to stand up for what's right? It starts off with your image of who you are, though. It starts off with your image. Now, let's get it. 1 and 14.
His head and his hairs were white like wool.
Hey, my young sisters, come over here. We have pictures right here. Come this way. Come this way. So you said Jesus was white, right? He was white. So the world considered this to be Jesus Christ, right? Right? Read it from top. His what?
His head and his hairs were white like wool.
So now, hold on, I got two more questions. Don't go nowhere. I got to answer your two questions. So he said his head and his hairs were white like wool. His head and his hairs were white like wool. He had white woolly hair. Which one has, does this man have white woolly hair?
No.
Who does that? Does this man have white woolly hair? There we go. White in color and woolly in texture. So if you feel your hair like that texture, woolly, yes, right there. Yes, afro, yes. There's more, read on.
As white as snow, and his eyes were as a flame of fire, and his feet like unto fine bread.
His feet like what?
Fine bread.
So it's talking about the color of his feet, right? Brass, not grass, but brass. You ever seen brass? What color is brass, you know?
Brown.
There you go. Good, brown. Now for one, listen, sister, listen. So for starters, is this, I'm gonna read on more, read on.
And his feet like unto fine brass, as if they burn in a furnace.
So if you take that brown and you burn it, is it gonna get lighter or darker? Is it gonna get lighter or darker? So which one is the true description right here? Point to it, point to it, point to it. There you go, that's Jesus Christ, he a black man. Don't forget that, all right? So what color is Christ? Black, exactly. Hey, my sister, we out here bringing out the image of Christ. Our people been taught to believe that Christ was a white man through mainstream media, movies, whatever the case may be. But reading the Bible, and we describe it, and it's described Jesus Christ as a black man. So where do we get this image from then? From the crackers. I like that. I like that. So what's your second question? Does God love everybody? Let's find out. Let's find out. Let's go to 2 Chronicles. Let's start at 2 Chronicles chapter 9 and verse 8. Let's start there. Let's start there. Does God love everybody?
The book of 2 Chronicles chapter 9 and verse 8. Blessed be the Lord thy God, which delighted in thee to set thee on his throne, to be a king for the Lord thy God, because thy God loved Israel.
You love who?
Israel.
You love who?
Israel. To establish them forever.
Who?
Establish them forever. Therefore, made he the king over them to do judgment and justice.
So who does God love? Israel. And his son, Jesus Christ, the black Messiah, who did he come for? Did he come to save everybody? Did he come to save Israel? Let's read it. Let's go to Matthew 15:24. You on point. Let's find out. Let's answer all the questions with the Bible. You notice we're using the Bible to answer every question. We're not coming out here using our words. You've been up here for a long time. Did we use our words? Did we use our words to edify? We use the Bible. Right. Let's see who Christ came for, because we already know that the Lord loves Israel. Read.
The book of Matthew chapter 15 and verse 24. But he answered and said, I am not sent but unto the lost sheep of the house of Israel.
See that? Christ only came for the nation of Israel only. He didn't come for the white man. He didn't come from everybody. Now, had it said that, we read that. But our people associate that with, oh, y'all racist. Remember, it said, woe to them we call evil good and good evil, that put light in darkness and darkness to light. We out here trying to shed light according to what the Bible say. All we out here to do is read in God's word. That's all we doing. Read it from, the top.
Now we got Matthew chapter 15, verse 24. But he answered and said, I am not sent but unto the lost sheep of the house of Israel.
So he was only sent but unto the lost sheep of the house of Israel. He sent for you to repent and wake up and come back to his word. He sent for you. It's some things you got to do. He only sent for the house of Israel. Let's get Deuteronomy 10 and 12. Because understanding that, what's next? Understanding that Christ is a black man that only came for you. Believe it or not, he came for everybody out here. That's why we out here. To let our people know who Christ came for. Because this is not going to last forever. America is going to burn. And when World War III hits. And you don't want to be in there in that day. You want to be saved. Let's get that.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 10 and verse 12. And now Israel.
Now who?
And now Israel.
Remember, Christ only came for the Israelites. So now Israel, understanding that. Come on.
What the?
Oh, say what? Yes. And we're going to show you more if you stick around. But we have to set the precedence. That first and foremost, this Bible is not for everybody. Christ is a black man, only died for the nation of Israel. Read.
And now Israel, what doth the Lord thy God require of thee?
So now understanding that, what does the Lord God require of you? Read.
But to fear the Lord thy God, to walk in all his ways.
We got to walk in all of God's ways. You're only going to find God's ways in the Bible. You're not going to find God's ways in the Christian church. You're not going to find God's ways in the Muslim mosque. You're not going to find God's ways definitely not in the Billiken. Because out here our girls looking like, dressing immodestly. Our parents out here not teaching our children right. And our young men out down the street fighting. Read on.
To walk in all his ways. And to love him. And to serve him. And to serve the Lord thy God with all thy heart and with all thy soul.
We have to serve the Lord thy God with all thy heart. The heart is your mind. So you always got to be focused on God.
What is the nation? Nation is men leading by example. Nation is family. Nation is community. Nation is children with role models. Nation is unity. Nation is you.
And